Please get ready for part 5 of the budget speech. 5 seconds. Start. Considering the fact that majority of people still live in villages and depend on agriculture and traditional industries, the scheme of fund for upgradation and regeneration of traditional industries aims to set up more common facility centers to facilitate cluster-based development to make the traditional industries more productive, profitable, and capable for generating sustained employment opportunities. The focused sectors are bamboo, honey, and khadi clusters. The scheme envisages setting up 100 new clusters during 2019-20, which should enable 50,000 artisans to join the economic value chain, further to improve the technology of such industries. The scheme for promotion of innovation, rural industry and entrepreneurship has been consolidated for setting up of livelihood business incubators and technology business incubators. The scheme contemplates to set up 80 livelihood business incubators and 20 technology business incubators in 2019-20 to develop 75,000 skilled entrepreneurs in agro-rural industry sector. We will invest widely in agricultural infrastructure. We will support private entrepreneurships in driving value addition to farmers' produce from the field and for those from allied activities like bamboo and timber from the hedges and for generating renewable energy. Annadata can also be Urja Data. Daring through cooperatives shall also be encouraged by creating infrastructure for cattle feed manufacturing, milk procurement, processing and marketing. I place my appreciation for our farmers who have made India self-sufficient in pulses. I am sure they will repeat such a success even in the production of oil seeds. Our import bill shall be reduced by their seva. We also hope to form 10,000 new farmer producer organizations to ensure economies of scale for farmers over the next 5 years. This government will work with state governments to allow farmers to benefit from e-NAM. The Agriculture Produce Marketing Cooperatives Act should not hamper farmers from getting a fair price for their produce. Ease of doing business and ease of living both should apply to farmers too. We shall go back to basics on one count: zero budget farming. We need to replicate this innovative model through which in a few states farmers are already being trained in this practice. Steps such as this can help in doubling our farmers' income in time for our 75th year of independence. Ensuring India's water security and providing access to safe and adequate drinking water to all Indians is a priority of the government. A major step in this direction has been the constitution of the Jal Shakti Mantralaya. integrating the Ministry of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation and Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation. This new Mantralaya will look at the management of our water resources and water supply in an integrated and holistic manner and will work with states to ensure Har Ghar Jal to all rural households by 2024 under the Jal Jeevan Mission. This mission under the Department of Drinking Water and Sanitation will focus on integrated demand and supply side management of water at the local level, including creation of local infrastructure for source sustainability like rainwater harvesting, groundwater recharge, and management of household wastewater for reuse in agriculture. The Jal Jeevan Mission will converge with other central and state government schemes to achieve its objectives of sustainable water supply management across the country. The government has identified 1,592 blocks which are critical and overexploited, spread across 256 districts for the Jal Shakti Abhiyan. Besides using funds available under various schemes, the government will also explore possibility of using additional funds available under the Compensatory Afforestation Fund Management and Planning Authority for this purpose. Swachh Bharat Abhiyan has touched the very conscience of the nation besides bringing enormous health and environmental benefits. This noble scheme, initiated in 2014, has achieved a resounding success. 9.6 crore toilets have been constructed since October 2, 2014. More than 5.6 lakh villages have become open defecation free. We have to build on this success. We must not only sustain the behavioral change seen in people, but also harness the latest technologies available to transform waste into energy. I now propose to expand the Swachh Bharat Mission to undertake sustainable solid waste management in every village. Under the Pradhan Mantri Gramin Digital Saksharta Abhiyan, over 2 crore rural Indians have so far been made digitally literate. To bridge rural-urban digital divide, BharatNet is targeting internet connectivity in local bodies in every panchayat in the country. This will be speeded up with assistance from Universal Service Obligation Fund and under a public-private partnership arrangement. The government sees the rapid urbanization of India as an opportunity rather than a challenge. We have to make both our cities and villages better using technology. This way, we can help people live closer to their home, stop migration into cities, provide essential services to all. Under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, urban over 81 lakh houses with an investment of about 4.83 lakh crores have been sanctioned, of which construction has started in about 47 lakh houses. Over 26 lakh houses have been completed, of which nearly 24 lakh houses have been delivered to the beneficiaries. There is large-scale adoption of new technologies for construction of these houses. Over 13 lakh houses have so far been constructed using these new technologies. Stop.